Hi, everybody. So I have shown Johan Eger Hadass's two books on my channel, and when I posted the last one, I was told that he actually had three books out. So the last one was The Norse Gods. And Lord and behold, that was right. So of course I had to get my hands on this because I want to show you all of his books. So thank you so much for the person that let me know that he actually had one more book out. So I will try to link this if I can find it on Etsy, because I know that it has been sold there. And if I can find it, I will link that. If I don't, there will at least be Scandinavian links for this book. Yeah, I have also shown the two other books, so I will try to put those in those small eyes that comes up there. So hopefully I will remember to link both of them. So that is Nordic Discovesen and then the Tales from the Death or something. I don't remember the name right now, and this doesn't really tell you. So let us see what this says about this book. Bring out your inner artist and color some of Johan Egerkrans. Oh, come on. Amazing artwork from the book Norse Gods. Among these 40 sketches are Odin, Thor, Freya, as well as other gods and characters from Asgard, Jotunheim and the Netherworld. So in Norway we have both Asgard and Jotunheim. So let's just dive right into it. So I guess that this is Hugin the Munin, Odin's two ravens. So sketches from the Norse God, a coloring book by Johan Egerkrans. So this book is actually in English. So for once, those of you who doesn't know any of the Scandinavian languages, you can actually also read about the stories that goes on in this book. So here we have a image from the now this book is completely new, so it wants to close up again, so I have to hold it down. This is a giant, and we can also see how big the giant actually is compared to the people up there. Maybe I should zoom out a little bit more, so to see to get everything. So you see the full image. Look at, and look at his hand there. He's also, that's going to be fun. Here we have a part of Midgard, which is a citadel in Asgard. We have the ravens there. This is Odin with his ravens, Hugin and Munin. There. There are both his messengers and his spies. So so here we can see he has this is the Yggdrasil, the tree of life, as we call it. Stories about one hanging for nine nights piece by a spear. So hung himself from Yggdrasil. Anyways, here we have Valhalla, where all the ones who died in the battle ended up. Here we have an image of Sleipner, Odin's horse. The fun thing about his horse is that it can run double as fast as any other horse, because he has eight legs. Now we can only see four of them here, but of course he has four at the back as well. So this is Sleipner. Here we can see Thor, I guess, or Thor as we call him. Many of you already know the legends about Thor. Certainly he is a superhero too. So Here is Loki that has borrowed, or borrowed, probably robbed her, Terrigus' skin of a falcon feathers. Loki is always up to something. So this is Tyr, one of the highest ranked gods of Asgard. So this is the Fenrir wolf. Oh, and here we have Freyja herself, which is a beautiful goddess. She is a goddess of war and death. She is very good at magic and fertility. So, oh, so you can see that she is naked under her coat there. Beautiful, beautiful. And it is of Freyja's habit to take younger warriors under her wing. So here we can see one of them playing their loyalty to her. Is a Liz, sorry about Freyja, and then we have I think that this is the giant called Mimir. Heimdall is one of the watchmans from the of the gods. It wants to so we have one of the dwarves that was going to make new golden hair to Thor's wife Sif after Loki had cut it off during her sleep. So this is Frigg, she is Odin's wife and queen of the gods. This is Idun with her beautiful apple. So all already knows her. That. The giant Taisi once forced Loki to lure Idun and her golden apples. So this is an image from that story. We can read some of it on this side here. The god, and this is a story about a time when the gods lived on Fyn, which is an island or a place in Denmark. The paper is very good because it actually feels like it is two pages, so it is nice and sturdy. Thick paper, it's quite smooth, but I know that from the other books that it is awesome to color on because it feels smooth, but it also holds the pencils quite well. So this is Balder, one of the most peace-loving jurist of all the gods. I love his horse. It's a beautiful horse. And Loki changed from innocent parents into actually being really evil and just mean. So here we can see a Viking ship on fire, and I guess that is Loki on the wolf. After Loki caused Balder's death, the Aesir gods took him to the underground. So this is an image from that. Oh, and here we have the Norns. They are not goddesses, but they are something more, much older and more powerful. So we have 30 of them. And we are being told about the Valkyries that I also lives here. That's Ravens here. Oh, and another giant. Oh, I love giants. I called that one giant in Vesen. That was so much fun. So this is another one. I love them. And you can color them like in any color that you would like them to be. Like if you want them green, you can. Yeah, I love giants. Fenja and Menja, who used to battle bears, are having a what looks like to be a battle between them, or they are filling their powers against each other. So this is not women you want to mess with for sure. So we have some dwarves, two different kind of dwarves. This is the witch giantess Angerboda. She lives in the iron wood. And of course the biggest kingdom of them all is Hel, or Helheim, the home of Hel. So this is Hel. And her gates are guarded by this big Hel dog called Garm. And fun fact that in Norway we have a small town called Hel. And what is more fun is that it actually freezes every winter. So, yeah. A Viking ship. Lots of guys on it. Warriors. Oh my god, what is this? I haven't seen something like this before. Looks like this the giant Hungnir. Who was in a old-fashioned duel with Thor. Here we have Loki. And you can see that he is not up to something good. He is always thinking of new plots and way to scam and fool people. I'm speaking of Norwegian as well. We have Egir and Ren, which is the king and queen of the sea. They have taken some fishermen, I guess. They have them in their fish net. So, I think this is supposed to be. I don't know if this is a Ragnarok, but this is a chicken and dragon roast, which is kind of the end of the world. And after the end of the world, the Himbulweather will come, which is an internal winter. And in Hel, all dead are awakened by the crowing of a cockerel, Belekus, sooth. Okay, sooth. So this is that bad black cock that will awaken all the dead after. The world has ended. So, at the end, good and evil has to meet on the plain of Vigrid, beyond Asgard. He sends Loki with his forces from the underworld. And Odin lives the attack. And hopefully everything will be good. So this is the last page again, the info. First published in Sweden in 2017, but it says Johan Egil Kenneth 2018 here. So I'm not sure what order these 30 books actually came in, or I know that Besen was the first one. So this is, anyways. I have this now. So I just wanted to show you Johan Egil Kenneth's book. So now I have showed you all Teari. Like I said, I will try to link to it, see if I can find it there now. Until next time, stay safe, take care, and I love you all. Bye.